Hey, how's it going? My name is Mark Bone. I'm a film director here in Toronto, Canada. I mainly work on documentaries and commercials, and I also have a YouTube channel where I talk about filmmaking, but I'm here today to tell you about the Loupedeck custom profiles that are available for the Loupedeck CT platform. And why you should be excited that I'm telling you about these today is I'm not that technical. I'm not much of a techie guy. I don't know how to program or do any of that. So the fact that I'm able to do this and I actually use these now is good news for you, because if you're a pro, then you'll certainly get it. Or if you're a beginner with programming and adding stuff into software, then you'll be doing just fine with this. So what is a custom profile? Well, it's a set of custom actions that are recorded for the buttons here on the Loupedeck CT and the knobs that can be used for any software. This is the good thing, is that you can use any software now with your Loupedeck CT. Now, unlike Loupedeck native integrations that use the API of the software, the Loupedeck custom profiles just use the available shortcuts in the program. So there are some limitations, but we're gonna show you a couple custom profiles today for software that previously you may not have used with your Loupedeck CT. So we're just gonna jump into the software now here. So if you open up the Loupedeck software, there's the application drop-down list. And at the bottom, it should say find more or get profiles. And if you click on this, it'll take you to the Loupedeck website, where it'll take you to a list of custom profiles that you can download that people have already created. So I'm gonna show you right here, I'm gonna show you Spotify. So I've already downloaded the Spotify profile. I'm just gonna come down here to the settings button down here in the bottom left corner. I'm gonna hit import. It's already in my download folder here, Spotify Loupedeck custom profile. I'm hitting import. I'm just gonna name it Spotify because that's what it is. And done, here we are. So now I have a custom profile for Spotify, and there's tons of options. You can see here in the custom actions, already there's things mapped out from everything from pacing songs, which I'll get into in a minute, to advancing to the next track, doing the maximum volume. And I can rename any of these things here if I don't like edit, because I'm not sure why you would name that in Spotify edit. We can just come here and click this, and I can say this is a playlist creation. I'm gonna delete edit here. There you go, and that's now been renamed so I can understand what that was all about. And you can map everything to the Loupedeck, whether it's the dials or just the buttons here. You can see here that you can use rotation for things like Spotify volume, or you can just use the buttons to press. And why I love this, why I love the Loupedeck CT, is because now I don't even have to know what the shortcuts are in the software mapped to the keyboard. I can just look at my Loupedeck and I can immediately see all of these custom buttons, where before I would just be looking at a blank keyboard, not knowing what the customization is, what is the quickest way to use this software. Now with these custom profiles, every piece of software, you can move through it like an expert, because you can just read all of the custom buttons without having to use two hands, because custom keys and hotkeys often require two hands to hold shift or to hold command, depending if you're on a Mac or a PC. And so this now frees up one of your hands, because you can just press one button on the Loupedeck CT, which is great, because humans usually just have two hands, sometimes just one hand if you're a pirate, but for the most part people just have two hands, so it's really nice to have that hand freed up for when using custom keys. But let's jump over here into Spotify, and I can start showing you this. We have play and pause here on the dial, the volume's all the way down, so I can begin moving it up here on the dial. So I can change the track here with the dial, just moving that over. We're on to the next track. Ooh, we had the dance party, this is a remix. Bring the volume down a bit here. I can even skip ahead the song, 15 seconds a bunch, come back a bit. And here's the great thing too, if you've ever used Adobe Premiere or one of the other pieces of software with the Loupedeck, you've seen that it knows the workspace when it's using the API. So they kind of have done that here in these custom profiles. Let me just pause the music. I can come in here and hit playlist controls, and now it's completely remapped. So I can just come over here into this playlist, I can hit select all, I can hit copy tracks, I can hit new playlist. What is this? This is the Loupedeck CT dope mix. And I'm gonna hit enter, and now I can just hit paste tracks. Bam, just like that, I have a whole new playlist and I just pressed a few keys, never really had to use my mouse much. It's awesome. I love being able to use the custom keys this quickly with the Loupedeck. So let's jump into some other software, and I know a lot of you are gonna be excited about this. Let's talk about DaVinci Resolve. So I'm gonna hop over here to Resolve, and we'll open up the Loupedeck software here. What's great now is any custom button, any hotkey that is available in Resolve, you can map to the Loupedeck CT. You can't use the Loupedeck CT in the color panel. Blackmagic doesn't allow the great folks at Loupedeck to work with that yet because their API isn't available. But any custom key that is in Resolve, you can begin mapping to your Loupedeck CT. And already there is a DaVinci Resolve custom profile available for download. So I'm just gonna click that here. We can see in the custom actions that kind of every panel that you have in Resolve here, media, cut, edit, fusion, not so much in color, but there is still hotkeys in color, just not working with the color wheels, is here over in the Loupedeck software. Something else that's really cool though is macros. And macros is essentially a couple of functions that are grouped together in one hotkey. So you can press a button on your Loupedeck CT and it can do a couple different commands all at once without you having to hit those keystrokes. So I'm gonna show you that here. Let's go back into Resolve. We have our edit here. This is some, zooming in. This is some footage from a film I shot a couple years ago that I was directing. Actually, there I am doing the slate. Look at that. One thing I gotta say too before I show you some of the macros is the Resolve mapping with the Loupedeck is so accurate. There's no lag. The software is really quick. I really love that. We have mark in here. I'm just gonna mark that in. Let me see, is that the moment I wanna start in the edit? No, we have our boom in the shot. Here I am giving the actors some notes. Let's just skip ahead. Look at that, I'm showing someone how to hug. That's terrible directing right there. here we are. So we wanna start the scene right before the hug. I'm gonna hit mark in. Now normally I would have to then go find the out, maybe with my mouse, and then hit out and then drag the file down. But I have a macros button here, which does all of that for me. So let's say I want the scene to end right here. I'm just gonna hit mark out and insert into timeline, and bam, that has done a macro. So it's done a few different actions all in one button. It's marked an out, and it's also brought it down into timeline. So for you, you can customize these buttons and add as many actions as you want into one keystroke. So if there's some sort of function that you're doing often, repeatedly, it saves you a lot of time having that. Another great feature is they've mapped the JKL button to this rotation knob here. So normally you would have that on the keyboard, but I can just knock it to the side. It begins playing, can press the middle, it can pause, can turn it to the left, and it's gonna rewind. Again, hitting the middle and it pauses. I find it very responsive in Resolve, the buttons with the Loupedeck CT. It feels like it's a surface made for this piece of software. And finally, I wanna show you how you can create your own custom profile, one that you haven't downloaded. So I use Safari and Chrome for different things. I'm gonna show you how you can map it to Safari if you're using a Mac. So let's go over here to our Loupedeck config. I'm gonna click this button and say create profile, and I'm gonna give this a name. It is Safari, and I'm gonna click the application list here, and you can see the Loupedeck CT knows every piece of software that I have on my computer. So I'm gonna tell it that I'm using Safari when I want to be in that custom profile. So I have no tools here. I'm gonna create a new custom action. What I would actually kinda wanna do is use one of these knobs here for zooming in and out. I usually use a 5K monitor when I'm editing, so sometimes I need to zoom in text. So I'm gonna come over here and click rotation when I'm clicked on this knob, and I'm gonna add a custom adjustment by hitting the plus sign here. So this is for when I'm rotating left, which would probably be zoom out, so command minus. I'm gonna hit the check button here. And then when we're rotating right is command plus. I'm gonna hit the check button here. And I need to name this. This is called zoom. Clicking save. And I'm gonna drag this over here to rotation. Now I have that. So let's hop on over to Safari, conveniently on my own YouTube page here. And I can show you, I can zoom in on everything here on all my lovely thumbnails, or I can zoom out with this dial. I actually use a lot of customization, especially for Gmail, so I'm excited to start mapping my own custom profile for when I'm using Gmail in Safari. And let me quickly show you here how you can customize a button. Let's go to press. We're gonna create another custom action here. And that is Command T. That is for new tab. This is called new tab. Make sure to hit check or else it doesn't save. Then I hit save. I'm gonna drag new tab over here to this button. And when we come back to Safari, there it is. And let's hit a new tab. Let's hit another tab. Let's get as many as we want. So there you have it. Now the custom profiles for your Loupedeck CT allow you to integrate this control surface into any piece of software that you have on your computer, which is really exciting. Again, it's not API, so you can't do all the full functionality. There might be some limitations, but any hotkey that is available in a shortcut menu should be able to be mapped to the Loupedeck, whether it's the dials or whether it's the buttons. So thank you, Loupedeck, for having me on your channel, and thanks for watching, guys.